So in this video, we're going to do some demonstrations with liquid nitrogen. Now, nitrogen is quite common. In fact, 70% of the air that you breathe is nitrogen, but it's a gas in the air. But if I get it cold enough, and that's minus 200 degrees, it becomes a liquid. So when I pour it into this beaker, it's boiling. It's going from liquid to gas. The fog you see around it is actually water vapor in the air condensing. So we get the fog. And I put it on the table, you can get some more. Now I'm going to pour this into a bowl. Won't last long, probably only last a few minutes before it all boils away. Now, this is pretty weird. I have some graham crackers. I'm going to put them in there so they're going to get really cold. I can put my finger in there as long as I do it fast. I can't hold my finger in there, otherwise it would freeze. So I have the crackers in there. They're going to also get down to minus 200 degrees. I don't know if you can hear it. I can hear it. It's still boiling. Just give it a little time. And then I'm going to do something that you would think would be kind of foolish. I'm going to take one of these crackers out. Let me see if you can guess what I'm going to do with it. All right. Got to be quick. It's cold. Another one. Quite cool. So now let's see what else we can do with liquid nitrogen. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to pour some liquid nitrogen into this water bottle. And what's going to happen is it's boiling in there. So it's changing to nitrogen gas. But of course it's able to escape. Now I'm going to seal it. So now the gas can't escape. And what's going to happen is the gas pressure inside this bottle is going to get very, very large, enough to burst the bottle. So let's see how much power that has. So I'm going to seal it. And let's see what happens. Okay, that one did not go quite as expected. I probably should have just left it longer. What I've done now is I put some water in there. So now it should go much, much quicker. And I'm also going to use a much stronger bottle and a bigger bottle because we want a bigger explosion than that. Put it in here. That was pretty good. Now let's go bigger. So this bottle is also strong.
but a lot bigger. So I'm going to seal it, trap the gas in there. Get out of here! I think that might be big enough. So anyway, that's what you can do with liquid nitrogen. Now for finale. Let's put a bottle in this cannon. So Dennis is putting liquid nitrogen in the bottle. What do you do to these ping pong balls? I don't think it's going to work, John. I heard hissing. And when it hisses, that means the lid's not on there. So Dennis, could you get a couple more bottles from the physics room? And we'll do this all again. It'll just take a few minutes. We'll do this all again. And if you can't find